If the brazing won't start or the unit's on-off light is dark when the switch is turned on, check the control fuse. If the control fuse is faulty or missing, the unit won't turn on. Replace with a new one, and the unit should turn on as expected. Check that the ground cable is properly connected and that there are no cable breaks. Remove the ground magnet and check the surface. In case of a rusty or uneven surface, grind until it's clean as shown in video. Always use Safetrack approved grinding materials. Attach the ground magnet to the surface once again, and make sure it's properly connected. Unplug the cables from the unit and check that both plugs and cables are okay. Once checked, plug them in one by one and make sure they are seated properly. Unplug the cables from the gun and check them for any damages. If they are okay, plug them in again. Always make sure they are thoroughly connected. Switch the setting knob to P1. Take the brass piece of the lift height tool and place in the pin holder as in the video. Insert the plastic piece into the ring holder. Hold the plastic piece pressed against the ring holder and press the trigger. When the brass piece sits flush against the plastic piece, the lift height is correct. Remember to wait a few seconds before pressing the trigger again. If the brass piece, as in this case, sticks out when the trigger is pressed, the lift height is too low and needs to be adjusted. With the included push pin, remove the plastic plug as shown. Then use the included hex key and adjust half a turn counterclockwise. Now, recheck the lift height to see if more adjustments are needed. When finished, put the plastic cover back. It's important to always store your brazing pins in a dry and oil-free environment. Remember to never let oil or grease anywhere near the cable lugs of the bonds. In best case scenario, a lot of smoke is created during pin brazing. Worst case, the brazing result is poor and the cable connection will fall off. If the brazing pin is loose in the pin holder, remove the ring holder by just pulling straight out and then tighten the flares on the pin holder with your fingers as shown in this video. Insert the pin again to see if more adjustment is needed. Turn the switch to the correct setting. Insert the brazing pin into the pin holder and then insert the ferrule into the ring holder. Ensure that the pin can move up and down without getting stuck in the ferrule. Place your cable lug or bond on the surface and place the loaded gun with the brazing pin inside the lug as shown. Press the gun against the lug and press the trigger. Hold for 3 seconds before pulling the gun straight out. Knock off the shaft from the pin with a hammer and you're done. Insert a pin in the pin holder and push down to see that the pin moves freely without getting stuck. As shown in this picture, the brazing pin is not centered and the gun cannot perform the brazing. Here's a good example of what that looks like when pushing the pin. Check the ring holder and pin holder for damages and exchange if needed. If the pin is still not centered, the main axle may be damaged and the gun needs to be sent for repairs. Before you start pin brazing, it is important that the unit has the correct pin type setting. P1 for 8mm standard, P2 for 8mm extra and threaded pins, P3 for 9.5mm pins. You can always find the correct pin type setting on the label on top of the unit. To check the battery status, attach the black clamp to the black terminal. Then attach the red clamp to the red terminal and the battery tester should start. If the battery tester does not start, the battery is dead. Press the back button once to get to the main menu. Press Enter for battery test. Press Enter for car. Press down for AGM flat plate and then press Enter. Press Enter for CCA. Press Enter to start the testing at 300 amps. The results show if the battery is okay or should be replaced. Here is a picture showing the results from a bad battery that needs to be replaced. Remember to always switch all three batteries in your S30 XC unit. Check for any loose cables and tighten them if needed. Remove the pin and pull out the bar. Lift off the top of the unit and disconnect the batteries. Place the top upside down and spray a small amount of lubrication on the cable entrance as shown. Remove the two screws from the underside of the top. Push the connector closer to the openings. Carefully flip the top of the unit and gently pull out the electronics. Inspect the electronics for any loose cables or burnt components. If everything looks okay, put the unit back together again.